When atoms interact, they form one of three major kinds of bonds: covalent bonds, hydrogen bonds, and ionic bonds. Covalent bonds are the strongest. It takes the most energy to break them. Although weaker, hydrogen and ionic bonds are responsible for many crucial molecular interactions in cells. An interaction between two molecules could involve many hydrogen or ionic bonds, making, in fact, for very strong attachments between or within molecules. Covalent bonds are represented by the dash between the atoms. Each bond represents a pair of electrons shared by the two atoms. Two atoms can share more than one pair of electrons. Single and double bonds are common enough, and you may have seen some examples of molecules with triple bonds, such as hydrogen cyanide. Intermediate covalent bonds occur especially in carbon ring structures. Here's the benzene molecule. In the illustration on the left, we've drawn the six electrons involved in the double bonds as if they were in fixed positions relative to specific carbons. But since these electrons are actually shared equally by all of the carbons in the ring, the stippled circle of electrons in the benzene ring shown on the right would be a more accurate representation of the molecule. Covalent bonds may also be nonpolar or polar. When atoms share their valence electrons equally, they form nonpolar covalent bonds, as in the hydrogen and methane gas molecules shown here. In water, the oxygen atom is much larger than the hydrogen atoms. Oxygen's larger nucleus thus draws the electrons from the hydrogen atoms more closely to its nucleus. The result is the oxygen acquires a partial negative charge. Each hydrogen, left with only its proton, has a partial positive charge. The Greek letter delta is used to indicate partial charge.